Datasets are simply sets of data that you want to upload to the application. Datasets in HCM Spreadsheet Data Loader, or HSDL, are about the set of data you want to load at a particular point in time. For example, if you were loading overtime records, a dataset might be the overtime for a particular location for a particular period. HSDL only allows one object per spreadsheet and loads data for that specific object. Data can only be loaded into HSDL through a dataset. We can't open a spreadsheet and start creating records because initially there isn't a dataset. The spreadsheets always start blank. I can search for a previous dataset. Once I've selected a dataset, I can search for only failed records or all records. There are two ways to create a dataset. The first is to create it and populate it manually. Now that the dataset is created, I'll manually enter my data. If I was entering a large amount of data, I could click Save to periodically save the data to the staging tables. If I've loaded data and I want to back it out, I can use the Rollback option. For smaller amounts of data, like this, I can just click Upload, which will save and upload the data. The execution status and the upload progress column give me the current status of the upload. I can see that the upload is complete and that two rows have an error. I'll correct the errors and upload again. I might not need to edit each line with an error. Fixing one line might resolve more than one error, as in this case of duplicate data. When I reprocess errors, any lines that were successfully loaded won't be reloaded. The application will also ignore any edits to lines that were successfully loaded. The second way to populate a dataset is to import the data. Once the dataset is created, I can import the data. Once I've imported the data, I'll upload it, and if necessary, go through the same process to correct any errors. I can also shape the CSV file that I want to load into a particular spreadsheet. I'll find and download the CSV template for the spreadsheet. Now I can enter the data here. I need to keep the first row because that lists the data I need in each column, but I can change the column order or remove attributes that aren't necessary for a particular use case. The other important thing to remember is that when I'm supplying data in a file and an attribute is lookup validated, I need to supply the lookup code and not the meaning. For example, in the active status in column E, I'd supply active in the generated spreadsheet, but A in the CSV file. Thanks for watching.